Hello, Strasser.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Hello, Strasser.
Yes. You
Yes, sir.
start.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Hello.
Good morning, everyone. On behalf of the organizing committee, I, Dr. Debojyoti Bhattacharjee, Assistant Professor, Department of Chemistry, warmly welcome you all to this national webinar on the theme Chemistry of Alcohols, organized jointly by Department of Chemistry as well as IQAC Majuli College. Today, we are lucky enough to have among us Professor Ramesh Chandra, Dean, School of Sciences, and Professor, Department of Chemical Sciences, Tezpur University. We also have among us our Honorable Principal, Sir Dr. Debojit Choigya, and Mr. Torun Choigya, Coordinator IQAC Majuli College, as well as Head Department of Chemistry, Majuli College. Now, I request our Honorable Principal, Sir Dr. Debojit Choigya, to officially inaugurate the webinar and say a few words. Over to you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Bhattacharjee. Honorable resource person, Professor Deka, Professor of Chemical Science, Tezpur University. Respected coordinator of IQAC Majuli College, very dear coordinator, president and moderator of this webinar organized by our prestigious chemistry department of Majuli College. My very dear participants, researchers and student friends who are attending this webinar from various parts of the country. This is for the, I think, seventh time that we are assembled here in connection with the conduct of webinar that our college has been conducting, has been organizing various kind of webinars, national level, regional level, on different topics, on different aspects of different disciplines. And this is today, this is our segment sons. So at a very beginning, I would like to convey my greetings, convey my best wishes to all participants, including the honorable resource person. Am I clear? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are clear. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Including our respected resource person. And also, I express my best wishes, welcome you all to this webinar. As we know that today's topic of webinar is on chemistry of alcohols. It's a very, in fact, very interesting topic, very common topic to be discussed. As we know, among the most common organic compounds, alcohols are also very, very important. We know alcohol possesses at least a least one hydroxyl functional group in their structure. Alcohols have higher boiling points in comparison to other hydrocarbons with equal molecular masses. Various chemical reactions like hydrolysis, substitution, etc. are involved in the process of industrial production of every type of alcohols. We know that ethanol and methanol are two kinds of well-known alcohols. These type of alcohols are or can be used in various applications like alcoholic beverage, fuel, solvent, in various medicinal or medical uses. Sorry, my phone is disturbing various kinds of phones. Various people actually are calling to me.
Okay, you are audible, absolutely audible.
So far as the case of COVID is concerned, because now we are living in such an era, which is actually totally covered by COVID-19. In this era, the use and importance of alcohols, actually the alcohol has used tremendously, as these are extensively used in preparing sensitizers. So we use sensitizers here and there. Right? In preparing sensitizers, generally alcohols are extensively used. But apart from that, alcohol possess some sort of negative as well as harmful effect. Alcoholism and chronic use of alcohols can be attributed to a number of medical, psychiatric, social as well as familial problems. Alcohol used to kill a huge number of Indians every year, either by causing alcoholic liver cirrhosis, cancer, or leading to road accidents caused by drunk driving. We can depict a similar picture in connection in case of our state also. I hope in today's webinar, in today's lecture, our respected resource person, Professor Deka, will cover all different toxic effects of alcohols, and he will also discuss the detailed chemistry behind the toxicity of alcohols in an interesting and attractive manner. With these few words, I congratulate you all. I welcome you all to this national level webinar, and officially I would like to declare that this national webinar organized by the Department of Chemistry on the topic chemistry has formally been inaugurated. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, sir, for your precious words. Now we are moving towards the technical session. Before that, it gives me immense pleasure to introduce our today's resource person, Professor Ramesh Chandra Deka, sir. Professor Ramesh Chandra Deka completed his PhD from National Chemical Laboratory, Pune, in the field of computational chemistry in the year 1998. He was a postdoc fellow in the Technical University of Munich, Germany, and Tokyo University, Japan. In the year 2001, he joined in the Department of Chemical Sciences, Glasgow University, as a lecturer, and currently working as a Dean School of Sciences, as well as a professor in the Department of Chemical Sciences, Glasgow University. He is a prominent scientist of India in the field of computational chemistry, and his research area includes molecular modeling, drug delivery, catalysis, nanochemistry, as well as atmospheric chemistry. Till date, he has over 200 publications in highly impactful journals and over 3,000 citations. Professor Deka has received various prestigious awards like Alexander von Humboldt Postdoc Fellowship, Bronze Medal of Chemical Research Society of India, Hindustan Platinum Award, etc. In the year 2017, he became the first person of Northeast India to receive the honor of Fellow of Royal Society of Chemistry, London. With this brief introduction, I cordially invite Professor Deka sir to kindly deliver his speech. Before that, there is a small announcement for the candidate participants. Participants, on the behalf of the organizing committee, once again, I request you kindly to keep your audio and video in your mouth and also not to present your screen throughout the session. If you have any query regarding the session, you can put it in your, you can write it in your chat box during the question and answer session. With this, with no further delay, I'm handing over the session to Deka sir. Sir, over to you.
Okay, thank you, Devasji, for the introduction. So, first of all, I thank the principal, Dr. Devajit Soikia, for giving me this opportunity to talk about chemistry of alcohol. I think sir has told more than what I wanted to tell. And is it now the slide is visible? Is the slide visible?
No, sir. No, sir.
Not yet. No.
No.
So I have to find out. But I share this one. So I am presenting a window. Can tell screen to be at a candle and this is what? This one, is it visible now?
No, sir, it's cut off, sir. Only it appears presenting. It only appears presenting, sir, not visible, sir.
And here again?
Yes.
Oh. What is the problem? And here again?
Yes.
Oh. And that is in here. What is the problem? Let's make it. And here again?
Yes.
Oh. And that is in here. What is the problem? ठीक है, एक दो तीन है ना, एक तो आ गया शेयर इंडेक्स इन
एरिया, दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम
थैंक यू प्रिंसिपल सर फॉर द नाइस इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट द कॉल एंड आई आल्सो थैंक डॉक्टर देवजीत भट्टाचार्य थैंक यू प्रिंसिपल सर इनवाइटिंग मी टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर इन दिस वेबिनार आई आल्सो थैंक ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट who has participated in this lecture. I will not talk about what is available in our textbook about various reactions of chemistry of alcohol. So I'll mainly discuss the effect of alcohol maybe in our body and some of the side effects. So I'll start with one festival which is called Oktoberfest. In German language it is called OK, so not OC, Oktoberfest. This festival is about 21 days, so in the end of September to beginning of October, so it lasts from the middle of September to the first week of October. So 20
sorry, 20 sir.
Yeah
sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Gin is not in the slide. Slide is not in the form of slide show, sir.
Yeah. I'll show it. Now is it okay?
Okay. Now it's clear. Thank you.
Yeah. So this is Oktoberfest, means October festival in Munich, in Germany. This October fest take place every year, and. It is like it is a very big festival. I think I had the opportunity to enjoy this festival two times in 2003 and 2004. There is a movie. You can have a look in this movie. So it is.
Like, here are many great festivals. One of the wildest is Oktoberfest here in Munich.
Yeah.
About 200 years ago, with the wedding reception of King Ludwig the First. Ludwig's party was such a hit, they've been celebrating every year since. Oktoberfest lasts for 2 weeks.
So,
it is not this day, sir. Movie is not this day.
Is it audible?
It's audible, sir, yes. But not audible.
So, I'll quickly finish just this is because it's a long video. Okay. So what is interesting is this cart. So these are all filled with beers. Beer tanks are carried in a big tank. So I think I'll quit. So in this festival, like during our Saraswati Puja, we do procession with the Saraswati Devi. So here this beer is taken as like that. So beer is taken in a cart, and there is a very big procession. So in my life, I have not seen a better procession than this. So, but what happened? Every day, about 6 lakhs people in the heart of the Munich drink alcohol. About 6 lakhs people every day. And people all over the world used to visit just to drink beer in this festival. But what happened? You will never find quarrel between two persons in this festival. There is nobody is lying on floor after drinking. So it is everybody is enjoying. So they are enjoying beer in this festival. But what happened in our in Assam or in India, when 6 persons are drinking, so everyone will know, the neighbor will know that this person, people have started drinking. So we started making noise. In our university, students used to break glasses. But in Munich, there are 6 lakhs people every day. drinks alcohol together, and there is not a single kind of quarrel or fight, or even nobody will be lying after drinking. So I will discuss why it is like this. So whatever alcohol may be this beer, wine, whiskey, brandy, whatever name you tell, all are made up of ethanol. So it is ethanol. And but ethanol is not poisonous. So it is not at all poisonous. But as soon as people consume ethanol, alcohol, it gets converted to acetaldehyde, which is poisonous. So acetaldehyde is very poisonous. So what I have written, alcohol in the human body is first converted to acetaldehyde, and then this acetaldehyde is converted to acetic acid radicals. So there are enzymes which are responsible for converting ethanol to acetaldehyde, and then acetaldehyde to acetic acid radical. And then these acetic acid radicals enter the Krebs cycle, which convert alcohol to carbon dioxide and water. If there is any problem, you just let me know.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So this is alcohol metabolism. Depends if the although we always tell about equality, but alcohol metabolism depends on gender. It also depends on race. Then size means how much people take, what kind of food we take, physical condition, so alcohol content. So these are this alcohol metabolism depends on this. There are genetic factors such as variations in the enzyme. Say these Punjabi people from Punjab, they used to drink glasses of milk. But in Northeast, if we drink one glass of milk, people from Northeast, if we drink one glass of milk, the next day we will have stomach problem, because we don't have the proper enzyme to digest milk. We have the enzyme, but the efficiency of that enzyme and concentration of that enzyme to digest milk is less than the people in North India. So North Indian people can drink more milk compared to Northeastern people, compared to people from Assam. So this is because of the genetic factor, so enzyme, which is responsible for digesting milk. Similarly, alcohol digestion also depends on genetic factor, what kind of enzyme we have. It also depends on environment, such as amount people has consumed, and what is the nutritional value of that person who consume alcohol. It also depends on body mass. So this belongs to environmental factors for metabolism. So the first enzyme which convert ethanol to acetaldehyde is called alcohol dehydrogenase. But the alcoholics, those people who used to drink a lot, and women have less of this enzyme. So this is alcohol dehydrogenase, ADH, is less for women. And then another enzyme, the majority of the ethanol is metabolized in liver. So here we got two enzymes. One is alcohol dehydrogenase, convert ethanol to acetaldehyde. And then we have another enzyme called aldehyde dehydrogenase. So it will convert acetaldehyde to acetic acid radical. And then finally it will get converted to carbon dioxide. Or some of the alcohol also remain undigested, small amount of alcohol. So those are excreted through lungs, urine, and sweat Because of that, I think when people consume alcohol, we get smell. So this part I have, and this, as I told in the beginning, ethanol is not poisonous. But the acetaldehyde, which is generated as an intermediate step, is very toxic, and it is also carcinogenic. So it can create cancer. So the mechanism is very complicated, but it has been proved that acetaldehyde is responsible for making for creating cancer. Second step I told, so make the product of the carbon dioxide and water. So there are three different enzymes which the body uses to convert alcohol to acetaldehyde. They are alcohol dehydrogenase, as I told, alcohol dehydrogenase. Then cytochrome P450. But this is active only when the person consumes a lot of alcohol. The alcohol cytochrome 450. There is another enzyme called catalase, and it metabolizes only a small fraction of alcohol. So majority of alcohols are degraded by alcohol dehydrogenase. As I told, it depends on gene. There are seven varieties of alcohol dehydrogenase. They are named as ADH1, ADH2, up to ADH7, and 19 varieties of aldehyde dehydrogenase. So this is they are also named as ALDH1, 2, 3, like this. So there are 19 varieties of aldehyde dehydrogenase. Out of these 19 varieties, most of the acetaldehydes are broken by aldehyde dehydrogenase 2. So this is responsible for breaking the, and it has also several classes, seven different classes. Of this, not seven, it has three different classes, aldehyde dehydrogenase. Unfortunately, these Asian people, we have a dehydrogenase called ALDH2×2 instead of ALDH2. So this is very unfortunate for us, and this. ALDH2×2 is only about 8% efficient compared to ALDH2. And in case of women, it is 10% less efficient. So they for converting, as I told, acetaldehyde is poisonous, and we do not have the enzyme which can convert acetaldehyde to acetic acid radical efficiently. So that is unfortunate for us and also for women. So this is the mechanism. So that part we have very less. ALDH, 2×2 is very less in our case. Acetaldehyde is very short-lived, but it is short-lived only to people who are having ALDH2. But in our case, it lives longer than compared to European and American people. I already told. And so although acetaldehyde is short-lived, usually existing in the body only for a brief time before it further broken down to acetate, it has the potential to cause significant damage. So this we should understand. So this is short-lived, acetaldehyde is short-lived, and it can damage to the bodies of European and American also. But in the case of Asian, so damage will be more because it can stay for a long time. We don't have the proper enzyme to we have the enzyme which is less efficient to convert acetaldehyde to acetic acid radical. So this is particularly evident in the liver, where the bulk of alcohol metabolism takes place. So liver, in the liver, it stays maximum time because most of the metabolism takes place in liver. So because of that, those people who drink heavily, so liver is getting affected. So alcohol metabolism also occurs in other tissues, including the pancreas and the brain. So it can cause damage of brain cell and in the cancer in pancreas. So you will find those who are heavy drinker, they will have this problem. In other parts also, it can damage other parts also. We will see in the, we have some slides where we will see. And as principal sir told in the beginning, the methanol. So, say methanol is very simple compared to our ethanol, but it is more poisonous. We have seen this picture in February 22nd February in 2019 in Gulagar, where about 2,200 people died, and because that alcohol was contaminated with methanol. So the mechanism is similar. So methanol is getting converted to formaldehyde now. So I told you acetaldehyde is poisonous. It is short-lived poisonous. Similarly, formaldehyde is also short-lived, but it is much more poisonous. So it can kill people immediately. So because of that, because of this mechanism. Mechanism is similar. Acetaldehyde is less poisonous. Formaldehyde is more poisonous. People can kill. Formaldehyde will kill the people. Acetaldehyde will lead the people to die. So it will not kill immediately, but it will kill later. It will create problem in the body. Means for a methanol, for formaldehyde, if formaldehyde killed us today, acetaldehyde can kill after 2 years, after 3 years, after 4 years, or after 20 years. So it will create a lot of other problems and then kill. And formaldehyde will kill us immediately. But both are poisonous. So now we see the some report. Say in alcohol, there are reports, alcohol kills 2.6 lakhs Indians every year. So in India, 2.6 lakhs people die. And sir told that we use sanitizer from alcohol. So why we are using alcohol? Alcohol can kill. Till now, there is no medicine which can kill coronavirus, but alcohol can kill. So because of that, we are using sanitizer. And how does it kill? So it can penetrate through the cell membrane, in the lipid membrane, not cell membrane, in the lipid membrane, and kill the coronavirus. WHO's report, there are some, this is the report from WHO, about 2.6 lakhs Indians die every year. Now, almost 1 lakh death occurs in India Indians' road every year are indirectly related to alcohol abuse. So about 1 lakh people die due to road accident in India, and they are related to alcohol abuse. 30,000 deaths among cancer patients every year can also trace to use of alcohol. 30,000 people every year die. Liver cirrhosis, so it kills about 1.4 lakhs every year, and which is due to alcohol. So now alcohol, who reports say that kills about 6,000 people every day across the world. So in a year, about 21 lakhs people die in due to alcohol. So it is much more dangerous than our coronavirus. In coronavirus, I think it is still not that much. So this is in graphical, in 2006, I could find out some graph. So liver cirrhosis, 1.4 lakhs, road accident about 92,000, cancer kills about 30,000 people. And then there are some other effects of alcohol. So in addition to its toxic effect, some researchers believe that acetaldehyde may be responsible for some other behavioral and psychological effect previously attributed to alcohol. So some examples, incoordination among people, that we know every day. So when people drink, there is no coordination among themselves. There may be memory loss, sleepiness, and effect of other other effects we can find out, we'll see. Alcohol can move easily through the cell membrane and then damage it. So because of that, we are using a sanitizer. Although in coronavirus, we do not have cell membrane, but we have lipid. So that can be damaged. So it can also generate gastritis in the body. Stomach has a membrane lining that helps protect the tissue from acid and bacteria. So we know this in our stomach, we have digestive enzyme, which is nothing but hydrochloric acid. And the pH of that hydrochloric acid is about 3. So if we hold that concentrated hydrochloric acid in our hand will burn. But God has created a membrane in our body against that acid. But when we drink alcohol, that lining becomes irritated. It causes inflammation in the form of gastritis, so in the body. So alcohol, it can penetrate. This condition can be triggered by acid reflux. Some methods are there. And it can also lead to permanent damage to the digestive system. So because of this, alcohol can penetrate through the membrane. And alcohol is found throughout our body. It can, because it mixes with water. As I told in the beginning, alcohol affects some people differently from others. So what are those people? If a woman and a man of the same weight drinks the same amount of alcohol under the exact same circumstances, the woman will, on the average, have a much higher BAC, means blood alcohol content, than the man. As I told, because the enzyme which is present in women's body is much more less effective than in men's body. This is because women have much less of the enzyme alcohol dehydrogenase that men do. Many East Asian and American Indians, mean red Indian, original Indian American people, produce a form of acetaldehyde dehydrogenase, which is called ALDH2-2, which is far less efficient at breaking down acetaldehyde than ALDH2. So I was there in Japan for about more than 2 years. Even when Japanese people generally don't talk, they talk very less. But when they drink in a meeting, so they talk so much, they will be talking and talking, and you have to listen. So, and this is the effect of alcohol in Japanese people. I have not visited China, but I met some of the Chinese people in Japan and also in Germany, but their behavior is also same. After drinking, they will talk a lot and also talk loudly. So this I already told. This can, this acetaldehyde, as I told, is poisonous and it can create headache, vomiting, nausea, and heart, other effects, several other effects it can create. So it is also responsible for many cancer, including cancer in the upper respiratory tract, liver, colon, rectum, or even breast cancer can be caused by alcohol. This occurs in several ways, including through the toxic effect of acetaldehyde. This mechanism is very complex, but acetaldehyde is responsible for causing cancer. Many, but this you should remember, many heavy drinkers do not develop cancer. So there are often people used to tell, I used to drink so much, but I don't have anything. I don't get headache. So they may not also have cancer. And some people who drinks only moderately or even once may develop alcohol-related cancer. Because our metabolism is different. Enzymes present in our body are different. Research suggests that just as some genes may protect individuals against alcoholism, genetics also may determine how vulnerable an individual is to alcohol's carcinogenic effect. So, some people drink he or she may not have any effect. Looking at them, we should not drink. I may not have those enzymes to digest alcohol properly. Then there are a lot of research effect of alcohol in a pregnant woman. So this is called fetal alcohol spectrum disorder, FASD. So there are a lot of research. You can, if you type this in Google, you will find lots of research articles on this topic. Pregnant women who drink heavily are at even greater risk for the problem. So they are poor nutrition may cause the mother to metabolize alcohol more slowly, exposing the fetus to high level of alcohol. Then the baby may not get necessary food. There are a lot of research on rat. So it has shown that when alcohol is given to rat, the growth of the fetus is very slow. Drinking alcohol during pregnancy can cause a range of lifelong physical, behavioral, and intellectual disabilities. What else we need? If we have physical disability, behavioral disability, and intellectual disability, and these all diseases are called FASD. Then here you see this teratogenic means the chemicals which affect the embryo. So alcohol belongs to that chemicals also. It can damage the embryo, or it can have some effect in the embryo. So alcohol can penetrate through placenta, and it can reduce the growth rate. Brain growth is also less. There are a lot of research on this. And say, brain imaging studies by CT scan or MRI shows abnormal brain development when mother consume alcohol. Ultrasound shows slow growth of the fetus. Drinking alcohol during pregnancy may result in miscarriage and stillbirth, premature delivery, abnormal heart structure, behavioral problem, infant death, mental retardation, problem in the structure of the head, eyes, nose, mouth, poor growth before birth, slow growth after birth. So there can be a large number of problems if the woman, pregnant woman, drinks alcohol. So when I was in Japan, we have a volleyball club. In that club, women and men. So we have a women volleyball club and men volleyball club. But while practicing, we used to practice together. And after practice, after play, we used to go for dinner. But suddenly, I found that one of the women, she stopped drinking alcohol during dinner. Then her husband was also there in that team. So then I came to know that they are planning for baby and they have stopped drinking alcohol. So this is because they know the consequence of alcohol, so they take care. Even when I was giving farewell, there was one boy from Romania. And that day he ordered Coca-Cola. So I asked him, why you are drinking Coca-Cola today? So he told that today I have came by my scooter. Other people will go by train, but but that day he came with his scooter. So since he need to ride the scooter, so he is not drinking. So after drinking, very few people in abroad drinks. Indeed. But in India, what happened? Many people drive after drinking only. So we have seen in front of my eyes, I have seen death after drinking, after riding scooter, after alcohol. So these are the problems of even for adults, not only for babies, for adults also we can have problem in brain, esophagus, heart, all integral part of the body. So if any one of these parts are damaged, we cannot survive. So alcohol has the potential to damage all of them or any one of them. So we have to be careful while drinking. So many people drink that they are very sad. Because of their sadness, they used to drink. But there is a quotation, people who drink to down their sorrow should be told that sorrow knows how to swim. So there is no example that sorrow, any of the pain and anything has been decreased or removed by alcohol. Now, briefly, I'll discuss this date you see in 2-2-1835. So, in 1835, in the British Parliament. So, this is the quotation of Lord Macaulay. And I think here it will be more clear in this one. So, I have traveled across the length and breadth of India and I have not seen one person who is a beggar, who is a thief. Such wealth I have seen in this country, such high moral values, people of such caliber, that I do not think we should ever conquer this country unless we break the very backbone of this nation, which is our spiritual and cultural heritage. And therefore, I propose that we replace her old and ancient education system. So here also it is bold. If you see ancient education system, so that has to be broken. Her culture, for it, the Indian think that all that is foreign and English is good and greater than their own. they will lose their self-esteem, their native culture, and they will become what we want them, a truly dominated nation. So this is the quotation of Thomas Bennington Macaulay. So who gave this talk? He gave a 3-hour presentation in the parliament, and this is the main quotation from that from his talk. So then they were surprised, and then there was discussion: have we done anything to damage their culture? Then there were some people told, no, we have started some damage in 1760 itself. So we started some damaging. The first liquor shop was opened in Calcutta in 1760. And when this shop was opened, nobody used to go to buy wine from that shop. So they used to give whoever passed by that shop, they used to give by free. So when started getting the liquor free, they also started drinking. And after a few months, they started asking more. And when people started asking, they used to charge money. So like that, that first shop was opened in Calcutta in 1760. So now we see in West Bengal, we have 2,500 liquor shops. These are official. Unofficially, we do, you know how many should be. In Delhi itself, there are 863 official liquor shops. Official means for state-owned. In Mumbai, there are 1,190, and in Maharashtra, there are 10,822 licensed liquor shops. In Karnataka, there are 4,500. In Tamil Nadu, there are 5,299. And in Assam, we have 341. But we know in Assam, each and every dhaba, even in pan shop, tea shop, everywhere we can find. So that are not included. So when we go, when we travel from Guwahati to Tinsukia or from Dhubri, Podia to Dhubri, you can calculate how many numbers you will get. This number will, this is very less. Official number is very less. So we started one shop in 1760. Now we have so many. And okay, so this is towards the end of that. Say when we buy one car, say 5 lakh rupees, and it is a petrol car. And when we buy, when we go to petrol pump, we are very careful because it is a petrol car. So that that person in the petrol pump may put diesel. So we generally get down and ask them, have you filled petrol only? So we are very careful. Why we are so careful? Because diesel, if we put diesel in petrol car, the car will be damaged. We are so much careful about the car because it will be damaged. It costs 5 lakh rupees. But our body is much more valuable. A 5 lakh to kya gari kerosene tel ami bharam ne kyo bharam no bharao karan engine to beya hoi jabo kintu amar horiror engine to kiman mulloban it is much more valuable than what we have car but we put all kind of things which can damage our health we put all kind of alcohol cigarette tamol, tobacco, so whatever we have, everything we want to put in this body, which is much more valuable than our car, but we are much more careful about the car than our body. So it is up to you which is more valuable. So you see, even our guru in a Kirtan Guha, you can find out the mention of mod So I have put some of them in Namaparat. There is something called Hotabuddhi Situzone Bamse. Domba Hankar Hodanuguse. Kurapai Satu Kore Sandal Nisturako Bule Horbakar. So this is, and this you see, Sri Mudda Manko Hewar Kota. Poimore Kore Zonmoko Vita. So I mean, this tree does not mean wife. It means Mohila, Maddo, Mod, Manko, Ebla Kota, Poe, Zie, Honor Poetake, Zonmoto Vita. Nubuze, Vedo, Wuptai, Gura, Ormogo, Kuribo, Nazane, Muro. So Ebla Kota, Pahando, Mordon, Muliata, Odea say. I don't begin not to let Kurise, Guruzanai, why get a man of duty at this. But here, taking him more main than the alcohol report for Bologna. Our episode, I was told that there was some talk about Radhigaram, the girl Phukan, who is the past PhD from Assam. So he did PhD in Heidelberg, Germany in 1890. So this is, we wrote this in Amarahom. In 2016, we put in Meghalaya Guardian in 2016 December, because December 9 is the birthday of Radhigaram Dekhel Phukan. Then on the same day, it also appeared in Assam Tribune. So this is his PhD certificate. So there were some controversy. So then we got the certificate from him. From Heidelberg University, where in this part it is mentioned that date. This is mentioned in Latin, and if we translate to English, so it will show 26 July 1890. So I think I have concluded whatever I was interested to talk. So thank you very much for our. This is before I conclude. Here you see Bunsen. So which we call Bunsen burner. So among the, there are, in the internet, you can find out the students of Robert Bunsen, and Radhigaram Dekhel Phukan is there. So as a chemistry student, we should be proud that our R.D. Phukan was student of Robert Bunsen. And this is all what I was interested to talk, and thank you very much for your attention. And I finally thank the principal of Majuli College, and then the coordinator of IQAC of Majuli College, head department of chemistry, Majuli College, and Devasji Bhattacharya for organizing this talk. Thank you so much for your kind attention.
Thank you very much, sir, for this very interesting and informative session. We'd love to hear from you in future also, sir. Now we are moving to the question answer session.
Yeah, if there is any question, so I'll be able to answer.
If you have any questions, please write it in your chat box. There is one question, sir.
Yeah.
It is from our head of the department, Zoology.
Tell me.
What about Apong, a traditional rice beer of Missing community? Apong is the main traditional rice beer.
No, I did not cover everything because there are mention of alcohol in our bed, even Sorak Samhita, the alcohol is mentioned.
Yes, sir.
But there alcohol is mentioned as a drug, means as a medicine.
Yes.
So there is a difference between medicine and food.
Yes.
Say water. Yes. Water is not medicine. It is food, because the medicine food means when we consume as a large amount, so it becomes food. So if we consume as a very less amount, so then it becomes a medicine, like say paracetamol. Paracetamol is drug because we take very minimum milligram level. And that is also for adult, it is given full tablet. For Sahil, it will be 1/4. If we give full tablet to Sahil, Sahil will die. So alcohol is also like that. In Apal and whatever traditional alcohol we have, the alcohol concentration is not much. Say when you visit some places in Arunachal Pradesh, instead of tea, they will give you apom.
Yes, sir.
But that will not harm. So there, because concentration of the alcohol is very less in that. But that also, if you drink throughout the day, then it will also become poisonous. But if you drink like tea, then it will behave like medicine. Say in Germany or Europe, whenever their custom is every day when they go home, before going home, they will take one glass of beer, one glass of wine, but they will not drink heavily. Yes. Similarly, we also feel like drinking tea immediately after reaching home or just before we start. From office, we would like to have a cup of tea and then go. But after drinking one cup of tea, if we offer another cup of tea, will you drink? No one will drink.
Yes.
Because we need only one cup.
Yes.
But but in case of alcohol, what happened, our people take one peg, then next peg, then next peg. So they will keep on drinking until and unless they get drunk. So that is bad. So if you drink a little bit, then there is no problem.
Yes, sir. Here's written. Written if, you
don't drink, if you don't drink, that is better.
Okay, sir. Okay. Here's written one interesting thing, sir. Apong is the main traditional rice beer for their traditional ritual. My grandfather is still alive, age 90, and drink Apong on daily basis. He is still in good health. They encourage us to drink Apong by saying it. It has medicinal value. What is your views on Apong?
I have already answered. If you use as a medicine, then it may be helpful.
Yes.
But that also depends on your body metabolism.
Yes.
So, traditionally many people drink Apong. Looking at them, if I also started drinking, it may not be good for my body.
Yes.
It may be good for people who are drinking, who are used to drinking Apong from generations.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, Dolesa, for this interesting question. Next question, sir. This has come from Anubhav Kashyap. Would alcohol have any effect in the body if the alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme is somehow removed from the body by genetic engineering?
No, I am not. It is not clear. That was the.
Would alcohol have any effects in the body if the alcohol dehydrogenase enzyme is somehow removed from the body by genetic engineering?
Then that will be more problematic because alcohol dehydrogenase help in digesting.
Yes.
So if we remove that alcohol dehydrogenase, then effect will be much more.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. But engineering, this business will not work in our body.
Yes, sir.
These are just jargon. Genetic engineering and other things are jargon. So our body it is much more complex than whatever knowledge we have about genetic engineering.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Next question is from this Kemi Life. Liver has a function called first-class metabolism. It will active or inactive the alcohol. How liver decide? Explain with your point of view.
No, I have not studied this part. Liver function.
Okay.
Yeah.
Andy Namsa has another question, sir.
Yeah.
Is the ALDH2:2 enzyme expression is high in alcoholic Asian people?
These studies it depends on genetic and all those races have been not studied whether these hydrogenases are more in Asia. But in general, it is found that the amount of alcohol dehydrogenase or acetyl dehydrogenase are much less in the body of people from Asia.
Okay. Can you wait for 1 minute? Another one is about to ask one question, sir.
Okay, okay.
Yes. When from Rasna Devi, sir, this question.
When
alcohol is taken frequently, it is very hard to avoid. Is there any scientific reason, sir?
Oh, there are so many talks about scientific reason. So, because our body enzyme get, say, when you become thirsty, you get the signal. Because we have enzyme to produce the signal. Similarly, when people consume alcohol, so our enzyme, there are some enzyme which get modified. And they are silent when there is alcohol, but when there is no alcohol, no, this enzyme used to send you signal, why are you not drinking, why are you not drinking, I need more alcohol. So there those kind of lecture you can find out. There are a lot of studies on that, and then there are also treatment. So we have to use some drugs to keep those enzymes silent, or to deactivate, or there are complex mechanism how that can be treated. But enzyme get modified due to continuous consumption of alcohol.
Okay. No more questions, sir.
Yeah.
Okay. So I think we are 1 minute, sir. Okay. No more questions, sir. So, dear participants, we are coming across the last part of the session, that is to offer acknowledgement. First of all, I would like to express my sincere thanks to our research person, Professor Ramesh Chandra Dekar, sir, for providing us his valuable time and benefited us with his wonderful speech. Thank you very much, sir. Next.
Okay, thank you.
Next, I would like to offer my thanks to our respected principal, sir, for providing us this platform to organize such a webinar. Please keep motivating us, sir. Next, I would like to thank our coordinator of IQAC and as well as the head of our department, Mr. Tone Fagia, sir, for his constant support. I am also thankful to our academic coordinator, Dr. Nayan Chema, sir, for his valuable suggestion. Next, the organizing committee is very much thankful to all the faculty members and office staff of Malali College family for their valuable support. We would like to acknowledge our technical staff for their constant support in the background to make this webinar a successful one. Most importantly, I would like to thank all the participants of different institutions for their active participation in the webinar. Last but not the least, on behalf of the organizing committee, I would like to thank each and everyone for their constant support. With this, on behalf of organizing committee,
that was like this so that Professor Subindu Roy, Dr. Nima, they are also sitting with me.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Okay,
sir. So, from the organizing committee, I declare that the webinar is officially closed. Thank you, everyone.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. হয় কি আপুনি কাটি দিব পাৰে নেকি Thank you.